Our directions in the next part of the parallel lines in the coordinate planes worksheet is to write the slope-intercept form of the equation of each line given the slope and the y-intercept. So let's go ahead and pick up where we left off with number 13, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. So really quickly, slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b, and that's where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So in number one, writing this in slope-intercept form, we have y equals mx, our slope, m is negative 3, so this will be y equals negative 3x plus b, which our b is negative 1. Y equals mx plus b. And since we're adding a negative, we can write that as subtracting the positive. So y equals negative 3x minus 1. And that's our solution in number 13. In number 14, our slope, or m, equals 5 over 3, and our y-intercept, b, equals negative 3. So when we have y equals mx plus b, we'll have y equals 5/3 times x plus negative 3, which we can write as y equals 5/3 x minus a positive 3, since adding a negative is the same as subtracting a positive. Y equals 5/3 x minus 3. Slope-intercept form for number 15, our m is equal to negative 1, and our b is equal to a positive 3. So we'll have y equal to negative 1 x, mx, plus b, which b is 3. Negative 1 times x we can write as negative x. So for number 15, we have y equals negative x plus 3 as our solution. On number 16, our m is 2/5, and our b is a positive 1. So we'll have y equals mx plus b, y equals 2/5 x plus 1. In number 17, our slope m is equal to 3, and our y-intercept, otherwise known as b, is equal to 0. So we have y equals mx, so that's going to be 3x plus b, which is 0. 3x plus 0 we know is equal to 3x, so y equals 3x is the slope-intercept form in number 17. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 18. At number 18, our slope m is equal to negative 1/2, and our y-intercept b is equal to a positive 4. So we have y equals mx, negative 1/2 x, plus b, which is a positive 4. Y equals negative 1/2 x plus 4 is our solution in number 18. For numbers 19 through 20, it says find the slope of a line parallel to each given line. Now, in order for a line to be parallel, that means they have the same slope. So if we're in slope-intercept form, a line parallel to that will have the same slope. So if we're in the form of y equals mx plus b, slope-intercept form, we know that that m represents our slope. So for number 19, if we have y equals 2x minus 5, a line parallel to that will have the same slope. So the slope in number 19 is 2, so a line parallel to that will also have a slope of 2. So 2 is our answer in number 19. In number 20, our slope is again 2. So if we were to write a line parallel to that, we know that the slope would also be equal to 2. In number 21, the slope of this line is 4/5, y equals mx plus b, where our m is 4/5. A line parallel to this line will have the same slope, so we know that that will also have a slope of 4/5. Number 22, y equals negative 8/3 x minus 4. So our slope for number 22 is negative 8/3. So if we were to draw a line parallel to that, we would know that that line also must have a slope of negative 8/3. So parallel lines have the same slope. And number 23, y equals negative 1x minus 2. Negative 1x is the same as negative 1 times x, so our slope in this case is negative 1, and a parallel line, that slope will also be negative 1. And lastly, number 24, y equals negative 2x minus 1. Our m in this case is negative 2, and a line parallel to this will have the same slope or the same m, so that's going to be negative 2. Numbers 25 and 26 are our critical thinking questions. For number 25, it says fill in the blank so that the lines are not parallel. Line A goes through 0, 8 and negative 2, 0. Line B goes through 1, 2 and 3, blank. So we're filling in this blank. The lines cannot be parallel, so they cannot have the same slope. Let's calculate the slope for line A. We'll have x1, y1, and x2, y2. So we have y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 will be the slope of our line. y2 minus y1 is 0 minus 8. x2 minus x1 is negative 2 minus 0. So our slope will be negative 8 over negative 2, which equals a positive 4. So for B, in order for it not to be parallel, it cannot have a slope of positive 4. So we need to pick a point that makes our formula y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 not equal to 4. So here we have x1, y1, x2, y2. y2 is our unknown, so y2 minus y1 of 2 over x2 minus x1, which is 3 minus 1. That's going to equal y2 minus 2 over 3 minus 1, which is 2. So we have to think of a y2 value that will make y2 minus 2 over 2 not equal to 4. The only number that would make it equal to 4 would be 10. If y2 was 10, we would have 10 minus 2, which is 8, and 8 over 2 equals 4. So y2 cannot be 10. Let's have y2 equal 8. If y2 equals 8, 8 minus 2 is 6, and 6 over 2 is equal to 3. So if y2 is 8, then the two lines A and B would not be parallel. So 8 is our solution in number 25. But really, anything but the number 10 would make line B not parallel to line A. So we could have chosen 9, 3, 20, negative 50, and so on, just as long as y2 does not equal 10. So y2 cannot equal 10. In 26, it says to write the equations of 5 lines that are parallel to y equals x divided by 2 minus 6. In slope-intercept form, we have y equals 1 half times x plus a negative 6. Since subtracting 6 is the same as adding a negative, and x divided by 2 is the same as 1 half x. So we need to write 5 lines that are parallel to this equation. So y can equal 1 half x plus, and we need to pick a different b value, because if we use the same b value, that would be the same line. So let's use a b value of 1. That's one line that's parallel. Let's use a b value of, let's say, 5 this time. That's another line that's parallel to y equals x over 2 minus 6. So that's 2. Picking another value, let's go ahead and use 2. 3. And let's use 4. So y equals 1 half x plus 1, y equals 1 half x plus 5, y equals 1 half x plus 2, y equals 1 half x plus 3, and y equals 1 half x plus 4 are all equations of lines that are parallel to y equals x over 2 minus 6. Because they have the same slope, but a different y-intercept value. And if you want to, you can write your equation. For example, y equals 1 half x plus 1. You could write that as y equals x over 2 plus 1. Either way is fine. I just like having mine in slope-intercept form where I can see that the slopes are all the same. So you can see that in number 26, you're going to have many different answers. Now, as always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Comment below if you have any questions or you need a specific problem clarified. And remember, all likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.